If there was a heads-up duel which captured the attention of the rail, then it was the intense and lengthy series of heads-up matches between the mysterious Swedish player known as Isildur1 and the poster boy for the online generation, Tom Dwan. Dwan appeared at Full Tilt Poker in 2007, while Viktor Blom, aka Isildur1, in 2009. By 2009, both of them had a reputation for being both fearless and feared poker fighters in various high-stake poker cash games. But the reputation of Dwan was still a bit longer established, especially in No Limit Hold'em. The time for the two of them to cross swords came in November of 2009. Back then, no one knew who Isildur1 was, but his excellent results, his aggressive style of play, and undoubtedly his amazing skills all contributed to making him a key person of importance, since he beat many professional poker players online, and it was apparently not at all important to him who he was going to play next. Up until this match, durrrr was widely regarded as the man to beat at No Limit Hold'em. The reality is that there was a whole new generation of No Limit talent already rising up through the ranks by 2009. Players like iCaxton and Jungleman12 were contenders, but as of late 2009, none of them had the bankroll or the desire to risk it all at the nosebleed high-stake cash games against the likes of Super Roll Tom Dwan. In the 3 years up to the start of November of 2009, Tom Dwan was close to $9 million in Full Tilt's No Limit Hold'em cash games, but that was soon about to change. Enter Isildur1. The start of a series of huge 501,000 heads-up games between the two young phenoms started on the afternoon of Sunday 8th November, running over into the early hours of Monday 9th of November. Over the course of many hours of multi-tabling, the pair played almost 7,500 hands at the highest stakes online at both Pot Limit Omaha and No Limit Hold'em. From the very start, it all went wrong for Tom Dwan. 7,375 of those hands were played at up to 6 tables at a time of 501,000 No Limit Hold'em, with the net result an $810,000 win for Isildur1. At the PLO tables, only 122 hands were played, but this resulted in a huge $409,000 win for Isildur1. 99% of all hands occurred at the No Limit Hold'em tables. Unsurprisingly, the biggest pot of the match went the way of Isildur1. The blinds were 501,000 and effective stacks were $287,000. Dwan took action with raise the bet to 3,000 from the button. Isildur1 3-bet to $12,000, aggressively as most always, and Tom Dwan called. Was Tom Dwan preflop bluffing when he called with his marginal hand of his? He must have seen the odds, and there were definitely a chance for both players to gain the upper hand. Indeed, the flop Queen-8-5 really was quite promising for both of them, as it gave topset for Isildur1 along with a middle pair plus backdoor flush draw for durrrr. Isildur1 laid out for $15,000 on the flop and Dwan flat called. Isildur1 raised to $36,000 on the turn that came 9 of clubs. Durrrr shoved for $259,996, apparently bluffing or semi-bluffing, as he was probably hoping for some good outs on the river in case the suite called. But Isildur1 did not hesitate much to call on this board with his pair of pocket queens, cleverly weighing the chances. The 3 of hearts fell on the river, irrelevant to both the opponents, and the pot worth $574,000 went to Isildur1. As Isildur1 ended the session, claiming he was too tired to continue, Dwan seemed a little peeved off. He shouldn't have worried, however, as it appeared that Isildur1 was more than happy to give durrrr a chance to catch up, as he replied, "I play you every day, please, I'm not running you, I'll play till you quit tomorrow." This match set the poker forums alight. Nobody thought that this newcomer could possibly pose a serious threat to the king of No Limit Hold'em, and many thought this win was just a flash in the pan. Over the next few days, they would see that this was not the case. And so, it was that on the evening of Monday 9th November, Isildur1 and durrrr met once again over several tables of $501,000 No Limit Hold'em. Having taken this $1.2 million blow from Isildur1, durrrr remained quite resolute and he was determined to regain his position, but the next day only led to another loss. They continued to struggle, the stakes were high, and the pots were beyond a reasonable range. In this fierce session, normally playing 5 or 6 tables of 501,000 No Limit Hold'em in this session, at some point they were even playing 10 tables at a time, which was very tough for both of them. This time the pair played a staggering 12,000 hands. Once again, the big pots flew, with 23 pots in excess of $300,000 and 6 over $400,000. The biggest pot of the session went towards Tom Dwan. Calling a 3-bet preflop with 8 deuce isn't really the kind of thing which will make you a lot of money in the long run. On this occasion, however, Durrrr gets lucky as he flops a flush against Isildur1's top pair, top kicker. Isildur1 still has outs to a higher flush, but the board bricks out and Durrrr takes this $497,000 pot. When the match finally ended, Isildur1 had added another $592,000 to his bankroll. Things were not going well for Durrrr, because as well as another shellacking from Isildur1, he also lost $366,000 to Ilari Sahamias, who joined the match for part of the session. On Tuesday, the pots were even bigger, including a record one of $695,000, which was the third largest pot ever played online at that point. Dwan was not done, however, and it looked like he could well turn things around. Over $1.8 million down to Isildur1 over the previous few days, he made a great start to another lengthy session, going $1.7 million up and bringing himself to almost even. It might have seemed that Dwan's losing streak was over, but Blom managed a glorious comeback, something he is still famous for to this very day. Not only did he win back the $1.7 million, but ended the session the next morning by adding another $858,000 to his bankroll. Here is the hand review of the biggest hand played between Durrrr and Isildur1 by BTS head coach MMAsherdog.
So Durrrr makes the 3x, and deep stacked, that makes a bit more sense than short stacked. Although it's a sizing most players won't use even this deep. I don't mind his 3-bet sizing by Isildur, maybe even a bit smaller, but yeah, it's fine. I don't mind it. Durrrr now goes for he 4-bets, and I think his 4-bet sizing is quite good. You know, it would be a mistake to go like 45k or so, just thinking, oh, we're super deep, I just have to go infinitely big, but yeah, I think this is a good spot. I think it's a good spot for this sized 4-bet. And Isildur now 5-bets, and you know, against most guys, you can throw away your hand because they got aces, but Isildur, of course, has, you know, much stronger hands on, much weaker hands on average than the, you know, than a nit. So Isildur 4-bets, and he's giving Durrrr a pretty good price. So Durrrr can end up still calling sometimes. I mean, there's 108k in the pot. So his next move could be all in. Let's see what happens. Boom. Okay, this is a bit boring because it's a pre-flop all in, right? But still, it's a 700k pot. Running it once casually. Wow. So, I mean, you can't really blame Isildur, right? I mean, he 3-bets, the sizing seemed fine, the 5-bet sizing seemed fine, and he didn't disconnect and fold, so I like the call down, obviously. As for Durrrr, I mean, it's hard to say because this was 10 years ago, and I don't know the dynamic between these two. Maybe they've been gambling for weeks, and, you know, this was standard, right? But even for 350 big blinds, this is a little bit loose. I would say that when Isildur 5-bets to 77k, I mean, you're getting a good price to play in position. There will be an SPR of just below 2. So I think calling is probably best. So, I mean, perhaps Isildur just had tons of bluffs in these spots and then this was a clear shove. But I think this is probably too loose and calling would have been a little bit better. Even though he's king suited, I mean, you know, for 200 big blinds deep, yeah, sure, happily getting it in. Or like pretty happily getting it in. 250, yeah, probably. But 350, that's quite a bit. Even against a guy like Isildur. So I'll give him a 5 out of 10. But I feel kind of bad saying that because we don't know the dynamic and Isildur. Well, the sizing seemed good, so I'll give him a 10. But I mean, he got an aces preflop, right?
It was Wednesday and Dwan was playing in High Stakes Poker Season 6. Viktor Blom was fencing with Patrick Antonius, Cole South, and Brian Townsend, but everybody was waiting for the continuation of the duel between Isildur1 and Durrrr. Unfortunately, more of the same is exactly what Tom Dwan got the next day. You had to hand it to Tom Dwan. He definitely was not taking his beating lying down, and the very next day, he got straight back up for more. The fight continued with Tom Dwan's attempts to get out from under, which only led to further losses. In a much shorter session, a mere 3 hours and 2,142 hands played over 4 tables of 501,000 no limit hold'em, Isildur1 completely ran over his opponent, winning $705,000, taking his winnings over Durrrr in 5 days to over $3.4 million. Here is one of the interesting hands played that day. Isildur1 had 10-7 suited while Tom Dwan had ace-jack offsuit. Dwan opened for 3,000 and Blom 3-bet, Dwan called and they saw 7-7-5 on the flop. This was most certainly a very good one for Blom. We know that Isildur 1 is sometimes too aggressive, especially in the early sessions, but this time, he checked on the flop, maybe trying to be less predictable. Dwan checked it back too, not sure what was going on. The Jack of Hearts on the turn brought the nut flush draw and top pair for Tom Dwan. Isildur 1 checked, Dwan bet 17,400, and Isildur 1 raised to 64,800. Dwan went all in for $159,498, and in this tough moment, Isildur 1 cleverly called. His trip sevens on the 8 of spade on the river earned him the pot of $343,000. The cumulative result of this legendary high-stake marathon-style challenge was disastrous for Tom Dwan. It was the worst downswing in the career of Tom Dwan. He had been doing alright and had never expected anything like this nightmare, before or after the challenge. There was plenty more action to come over the next few weeks, with Isildur 1 winning almost $5 million from Tom Dwan and at one point going up over $6 million at Full Tilt Poker. However, when Isildur 1 has a bankroll, the sharks will continue to circle. In the next episode, we'll talk about the biggest day in online poker history and the downfall of Isildur 1. This video is powered by Bluff the Spot, the best place to learn how to win at poker from actual high-stake coaches like MMAsherdog. Check the link in the description. And if you like this video, leave a like, subscribe to our channel, and we'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye.